Hi, I'm Ben.
And I'm John.
And together we're OCB.
Reactions.
And today we have it was kind of an odd request.
Yes.
I was, you know, just doing nothing, like I like to do, and because I'm very good at it, as you can tell from my gut and my prodigious butt, which I'm covering up with this table. Anyway, I got a message on my phone from off Messenger, some name I didn't write, called Ripio, and it was a video from a guy in Argentina who apparently watched, you know, the Metal Around the World, which you should too,
because yes,
there's some really good bands there. So they're all good bands. Metal Around the World, damn it.
Yeah, I don't think we've actually had one that we've ripped on.
Well, I mean, that's
well,
not
we're
the point.
Picking, yeah,
we're cherry picking. But,
yeah.
Yeah. It's like, okay, but there's a couple countries that didn't have very many. So, like, we could have, like, in Afghanistan, it sucked, you know.
Yeah, because they have one band.
Yeah. But he sent me this video, and it's like, I don't know what the hell you want me to do with it. Oh, but I watched it. I'm like, well, shit, can't react to it now. So I, oh, he has other songs. And I told him, like, I liked your song. And I'll do a reaction to one of the other ones.
Yes.
And he's like, okay, well, just let me know. I'm like, okay, I will do that. So this is Ripio, De Que Se Rien Los Idiotos, which, something of idiots.
Yeah.
I just don't know what Rayan is. That's the only word I don't recognize.
Yeah, we'll have to Google.
Maybe we'll put it up or something. It's like, Ben's a dumbass, took 9 years of Spanish, doesn't know what this one stupid word means.
Yeah.
But I'm starting to think it has something to do with the sun or rays or something.
You're reaching for it.
Yeah, and I'm just going to look more stupid, so I'm going to shut up. So if you do the thing, I guess we're going to start it on its own.
Please like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share. Get the word out about our show and the bands we feature. And don't forget to drop a comment for songs that you want us to react to. And also check out our description. Go down through there because we do leave links to the videos that we're reacting to. There's also a link to our GoFundMe where we're trying to raise funds improve the quality of our show for you.
Yep, I mean, really try. I mean, you guys, over, we're gonna get dancing girls.
Shh! It was supposed to be a surprise!
No, it's just gonna be a dude in a bear suit with his dick out. Sorry.
We are not having dancing bear over.
No. Not if he wants to keep his tongue. Anyway, that's more for the gallows. Okay, we'll have Dancing Bear over for OCB Gallows.
I will not be present for that episode.
I don't blame you. Neither will I. It'll be an accident. I don't know how we feel in that news. But anyway, sick bitches. All the way around. That's not gender specific.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is Ripio de Que Se Rien Los Idiotas.
Old school metal,
yeah,
feel.
Classic metal feel, like metal, you know?
Yeah. This is before all the subgenres and everything.
Yeah,
this is just
like,
bang your head and enjoy the music.
Yep. Yeah, go ahead.
Contra mío han de venir. Abatido.
surprises.
No.
I mean, other than like I'm enjoying the hell out of it. Yeah. It's throwing me back to the...
This is going back to like old Ozzy and Quiet Riot.
Yeah.
This is just metal. And I'm loving the hell out of it.
Same here. And it's like I'm really getting an extra kick out of being in Spanish.
Yes.
It's the way that language...
The way it flows.
Yeah, it flows. I kind of want like the next Anthrax album to be in Spanish. Or the New Testament. Because I know it's coming out. Chuck Billy, go back and sing it all in Spanish. Or your native, you know, because I know you're Native American. And I don't know if you speak the language or I don't know anything about your, you know, living situation. Or if you ever lived on a reserve, you just lived in San Francisco or whatnot. But if you speak that other language, sing in that once. You know, that'd be cool.
Yeah. But no, I'm loving this. This is great. This is taking me back into my childhood when I first discovered metal.
And yeah, it's like why I got into it.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
And I'm pretty sure it's newer too. Yeah. So that's what I'm loving about it is there are still people out there wanting to keep the old sound going.
Yeah, it's just, it's just fun. He's coming up in a video, like, which we're not showing a video,
right?
But like, if you go to this video, which we'll have links to, you'll see his face, backlit and kind of white and whitened. He does kind of look like Marty Feldman from Young Frankenstein. It's just like I said, like, oh, this is gonna be funny. But it's like, yeah. And but bringing that up, I kind of like the fact that he knows his range.
Yes.
He stays in it, and he's still very effective.
Yes. The only, my only complaint at this point is I wish maybe his vocals were a little farther forward and did not have that reverb on them. A little reverb is good. To me, it seems like maybe there's just a touch too much reverb to it.
I mean,
it could be for the effect of the song too.
It could be, and he's the guitar player, so he might just not be that comfortable.
Right.
Or he doesn't. It's so much, or he's like not exactly happy with what he hears, so he's like, well, we'll tweak it a little bit. But I think he's got a fine voice. It's just,
oh yeah.
Almost went off.
Yeah,
almost.
could not have had this feel of a song without a good solo.
No. And you got it. Wasn't the most complicated or flashiest solo, but man, it had so much feeling to it.
See, that's just it. A lot of people miss is they think that, you know, a good solo's got to be this, you know, up and down through it. No, a good solo adds feel to the song.
And that's exactly what that did. That's,
yes. It doesn't have to be incredibly complicated to add its own voice.
No, it doesn't. Not every solo has to be Malmsteen or Children of Bodom or
like
3,000 finger taps and a couple like screams and like a crap ton of noises like Kerry King
inside like 4 seconds.
Yeah, it's like no, that's you just want to add to the song. You want to take it up enough.
A good solo is almost like adding a second voice.
Yeah.
Into the song is what it should be doing. It shouldn't actually, you know, draw you away from it.
No, it should suck you in a little bit more. It's like, and I thought that was we've had a lot of good solos on the show. I was like, but that one just like kind of sticks out to me because it's just, this accentuates the feeling of the song.
Yeah. We've done like a lot of the prog stuff and whatnot, and a lot of it, they do get into the really technical and, you know, complex soloing, and it's like, which I enjoy that.
Yeah.
It's just this right here, it was perfect.
Yeah. It's like, reminds me of like early Mustaine solos.
Right.
Because they just like, oh, that's the solo that had to be played.
Exactly. Well, let's get this finished out.
Song better than the other one he sent me, the one I had already listened to.
Yeah, I really, really hope that more bands out there start doing this.
Yeah.
Going back to the old sound, I almost guarantee if there's any of the youngers out there listening right now, because of us old farts.
Playing our angry death metal.
They're going to say, well, it's not metal. This is just rock. No, that is metal.
Yeah.
This is the sound where it's where the modern sound came from.
Yeah. Yeah.
And somebody just pulling it off like that, I'm loving it.
It's just a really good, solid metal song.
Yes.
Don't think he was actually on the list when I went through for Argentina.
Oh, okay.
So would he have made the cut for Metal Around the World? I'm very pleased with what we chose.
Yeah.
I don't know that he, but it'd been so close. And yeah. I would have. Anyway, I just really love the song. Thank you for introducing me.
Yeah.
Introducing yourself.
I'm going back and listening to more of his stuff.
He's only got 3 up on YouTube. I don't know. I hope he's got albums out, because I'd like to get them. And yeah,
yeah, because this was great. Like I said, it's going back to the days of Ozzy and Dio and, you know, Quiet Riot. This is true heavy metal.
It's metal, which is true. It's called true metal now, I guess.
Oh,
that's the genre they put it in. Like, oh, that sounds like metal church. That's true metal. Well, then what's all this other crap?
Screw fake, you. Fake it's metal.
It's fake metal.
It's just metal. I am we've gotten off on this. I'm not going to go into a total rant, but I'm just so sick of the subgenres.
I mean, it's a marketing ploy, it's the one way you can sell, like, give people identifiers. Like, this is grindcore. So, okay, so I've heard this grindcore band, so I'm assuming it's kind of like this, and then it's not, but it's like, meh.
It's getting to a point where, you know, you're going to start seeing things like Doomface Horrorcore or something. I'm just so sick of it. It's like, just, you know what? Let's break it down. Just start calling metal metal again.
I mean, there are different fans. Like, I like this kind. I can see why they're there. But you can use bigger generic ones. Like, this is death metal. This is... Actually, you just go like extreme, regular.
Yeah.
That fits. I mean, that's regular metal.
Yeah. But, no. That's loved it. And going back and listening to more.
Yep. So thank you so much, Mr. Ripio, for sending me that out of the blue. If you're a band out there and you want to do that, throw me off for 3 days the way he did, go ahead. I don't care. I'm not giving you my full name right now. It's not that hard to find, but...
Right.
But, yeah. Feel free.
Well, before we close out, please like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share. And please, you know, drop comments, give us more songs to react to. Check out in our description for links to the videos and to our GoFundMe.
Yeah. So, fairly well.
Thank you.